Are you wondering how to play Falcon BMS online with your friends? I will explain that process in this video. If you have any questions, feel free to comment down below, but don't forget to reference Chapter 6 in the BMS User Manual, where it goes into great detail. If you are new to the channel, I create Falcon BMS tutorials and DCS content along with missions and other aviation-related topics. I hope my channel is what you're looking for. Multiplayer in BMS is where it really shines. If you fly in single player, that's fun as well, but multiplayer is really where it's at. There are two types of servers. You have a dedicated server, which is a separate computer hosting and running Falcon BMS while everyone else joins. You also join that server as well. Usually that other computer is in your house. The second way to host a server is, I like to call it, a self-host, where you host and you join your own server on one computer. This will work perfectly fine if you're in a small group. However, in a large group, a dedicated server might suit you a little better. First thing you want to do is go to speedtest.net and run a speed test of your computer. So you want to write these two numbers down. You can move the decimal point three times. So this will be 592,000 and 58,000. You want to write those numbers down as you'll need 70% of the up and down speeds. A good rule of thumb is to use 2,000 megabits per person joining your server to make sure you have enough bandwidth for everyone. So after you found your upload and download speeds, you have to go into your router settings. You can search how to do that on Google, and you need to open up ports on your router. As you see here in the manual, BMS User Manual, Chapter 6, it is BMS needs UDP ports 2934 and 2935 to be opened and forwarded. IVC, which is the other program we use for radios, needs UDP ports 9987 to 9989. This is everything between, so it's 9987, 88, and 89 to be opened and forwarded. Once you Googled how to open up ports on your specific router, then you can go to Google and search what is my IP, and it'll give you your IP address. This public IP address is what you will give others to connect to your server. To test your server, you might want to have a friend to reattempt logging into your server to make sure that they can log in. So the step to launch a server is open up the BMS launcher. Once that comes up, you'll have this IVC server, which is our radios. Make sure you click on that. Once you click on that, this window will pop up. All that's normal. So there's a server for the IVC. After that, press launch. Once you're on the main menu, go ahead and press multiplayer. Go ahead and choose the IP4. This is where all your multiplayer phone book entries will be once you press save. So once you click that, go ahead and press new. There's new entry here, so you can put whatever you want to name it as. So I'll put server for this one. Connect to IP address. This is how you could loop back into your own server. So you could play on it. Also make it public for others to join your public IP. This IP address will be 0.0.0.0. This is what you put into that box. So that 70% upload and download, you'll put it here. So my download was about 600,000. So I'll put 600,000 in there. Multiply that by 0.7 to get 70%, 420,000. So you can put that, or you can put a little less if you want. So I'm going to put 420,000 in there. And then my upload bandwidth was about 60,000, so it's the same. So it's just 42,000 in the bottom there. Basically what this is it's allowing your Falcon BMS to use this much of your bandwidth. This is why you only put 70%. You don't want it to use all of it because it'll start lagging other things in the house or it'll start lagging stuff in the game. So make sure you only use 70% or so. And then after down here, you put in the loopback for IVC, 127.0.0.1. After all that's in there, you can go ahead and press save. It'll save it to a new server here. So again, if you're using this as a self-host, you'll have it exactly it is right here. You'll have your server name, connect and IP, and all that stuff. These are two checked. If you're using it as a dedicated server, you can have all of this the same, but you just uncheck these when you connect. All it does is just minimize the amount of people on your IVC server. There's no reason to have your actual dedicated server to be on IVC, so that just mitigates that. After that, you press connect. Once you press connect, it'll say a connection established. This doesn't really mean that you're actually live. It only means that it established on your own computer. So to make sure that it actually worked, make sure you have someone else log into your server using the public IP address that you give them. So once your server is live, you need to choose what mission mode you'll be doing. This will work both for the dedicated server with two computers and the self-host with one computer. If you're hosting with your dedicated server, make sure you're doing this on the dedicated server. So if you're going to use tactical engagement, go ahead and click on that. Click on saved choose your saved tactical engagement that you created. Click on it. On the bottom right, you'll have commit online. Once you have commit online, go ahead and click on it. Right here is where you have the game's name. Leave that the way it is. Password, if you need a password, and everything else, you could look it up in the manual and see what everything does. But for the most part, you can leave all of this as default. Press OK. It'll connect. If you don't want the timer to be going, make sure you press halt on the timer to make sure it doesn't start counting down when people join. Now this is where it's slightly different. If you're doing a self-host, then you are hosting the server and being a client slash player at the same time. So with that being said, you'll just do the same thing as you would if you were joining someone else's server. So you would just join one of the Mustangs or whatever flight you're going to be in, and you can join in 3D just like everyone else. So there's an important rule when it comes to hosting servers on BMS. So the server has to be in 3D before anybody else can join into 3D with you. 3D is like being in the cockpit in the game. So once you join, people will join 1 minute after you when it comes to the countdown on the countdown screen. So don't be alarmed when you're joining before everyone else. So just that in Falcon BMS, the server needs to be in 3D before everyone else. And moving on to a dedicated server. So if you have a dedicated server and you have a second computer, make sure that you're doing this on the second computer. So you'll be in the server on your dedicated server. Go to another squadron. Usually you create a squadron while you're creating the mission, and you'll use it as a server squadron. So this aircraft won't leave the ground. You'll keep it on the ground, and it'll stay there because someone has to be in 3D. In this case, it is your server. So once everybody does the briefing, and once everybody is ready to join, go ahead on your server, click on the plane that you want to use as your server, which is usually a singleton something that it can be that could stay on the ground. Once you have it there, go ahead and go times one. At this point, you can have everyone start joining, clicking takeoff. And once you click takeoff, it will start counting down on their screens as long as you have times one here. Make sure you're in times one. On the server, press takeoff, and depending on what start you want to have initially, make sure you choose the same as everyone else. So if you're all doing a ramp start, go ahead and choose ramp start. If you're all doing a taxi start, go ahead and choose taxi start, and don't choose runway. So once everyone is on this screen and the countdown's going down, your server will go in 1 minute before everyone else's takeoff time. So this timer is irrelevant. It'll only go off of the takeoff time of everyone else. Once the server is in 3D, everyone else will start joining 1 minute after, and after that, everything is normal. So here's how to host a campaign. It's a little bit more difficult, but you could do it once you get it down. So if you're going to self-host, it's just about the same way as if you're joining a regular campaign. So you join the campaign, you choose where you want to fly from, and you choose the squadron you're all going to fly from. Press commit online. Once you're in there, everyone else can join with you as well. So you'll just join a normal aircraft and you'll just hop in just like everyone else. Just remember that you have to be in 3D before everybody else. So you'll be in 3D about a minute before everyone else. Other than that, everything is about what you're used to when it comes to playing online. If you leave this page, everyone will have to join again. So if you are the server, make sure you don't leave this page unless you tell everyone to hop out. If everyone doesn't hop out, you'll have a multiple online sessions here that has everyone in their own little session. So make sure you ask everyone to hop out before the server hops out. Now, if you're the dedicated server, it's slightly different. Go into whatever campaign you saved. I personally would recommend you have your own server squadron that has either an aircraft that could stay on the ramp for a long time, so a C-130. You can do this in Mission Commander. You have to turn off HQ, so the campaign won't automatically create flights. So this is Mission Commander. It's used to edit your tactical engagements and campaigns in ways you can't in Falcon BMS. You can change how many members are in your flight. You can change the airfield where the squadron will be taking off from, and much, much more. If you want to learn more about Mission Commander, I have a link below talking about it more in detail. Once you open it for the first time, these lines might be blank because it doesn't know where your Falcon BMS install folder is. Press File, BMS Location, and then find your location of your BMS install. lead it to the launcher, press open, and it'll load everything when it comes to that particular install for Falcon BMS. So first you got to save your mission, and then after you save it, you open mission, you find your mission. If you're in a different theater, you can go to your add-ons, so go to Balkans and then Campaign, it'll be in there. But in this case, I'll be using KTO, so I'm just in normal campaign. And if you can't see your campaign here or your tactical engagement, right now I'm in campaign, you can go to this drop-down, go to tactical engagement. This will show all your tactical engagements. But I need campaign, so I'll choose that. Mine is named Iron Camp. Gonna open that, let it open, and it'll show everything on the map here. If you're wanting to edit a squadron, you go to units. You can select what country, so US in this case. Go to squadrons. It'll show you all the squadrons. Gonna edit by name. I created a squadron that's the server, has C-130, so you can choose whatever one you want. Just make sure you know where it is so you know where to click on when you go into the server. So I named this as server. Double click on it. You can change the name here. It's zero. Change the name there for server. You go here to go to move airbase. You can click on that, and you can just click on whatever airbase you want it to go to. Click on it, it went to the other base here. And all you have to do is just click on a base, and it'll automatically do it. Or you can go to the drop-down if you know exactly what the name is of that airbase. Then you press apply, but in this case, I'm going to press cancel. After that, you need to uncheck this. It should be checked by default. But if you want to be able to control your server squadron and create flights on your own without HQ creating that flight, go ahead and click on that. Make sure it's unchecked. So if time passes in your campaign and you have that checked, it'll automatically create flights. So if you have flights in there already, go ahead and press clear on the schedule. So to clear all the aircraft that have flights, press apply. Once you press apply, go ahead and go to flights. Once you're on flights, look for the type of aircraft that you have on your server to make sure that there's no multiple flights. So here's a C-130H. It is taking off from Gimhae, and that's the squadron that I am using for the server. So if you have multiple flights in there, so let's go ahead and click on the top one. You can click, and then you click on the bottom one. It'll select everything, right click, and press delete. Once you do that, you'll be able to create a flight, and it'll be the only flight when you're back in 3D. Once that's done, press save. After you press save, you can open up in Falcon BMS. That's done, press save. After you press save, you can open up in Falcon BMS. See how I have it human controlled, so the campaign doesn't create a flight for me. So usually you use this as a 24/7 server. So you'll just create a flight, right click, add package, add the flight you want to use. So we had a C-130 squadron. I'm gonna only have one. I'm gonna choose the squadron that I use. I named it Zeroth Airlift Squadron, so I know which one it is. I'm going to press OK. So being that you want to be in 3D before everyone else, and they may join whenever they want, you want to make this about 20 minutes before the current time. By default, it usually does a pretty good job. So go ahead and press OK. Now this is your flight here. Go ahead and click on the flight. And now it's time is going. Press takeoff and ramp. This number will accelerate if you're above the default time for ramp start. In this case, the ramp start is within a minute, so therefore it'll go times one. Once it gets down to the default time, it will kick you into 3D, and then people can start joining. So once your server is up like this, you can just leave it here and turn off the monitor on your server and just let it run, and people can join whenever they want. So this is the server that I'm running right now. If you're not next to your server, you'll have to find a way to remotely log in into your server to update it and manipulate it if need be. Right now I'm using Google Remote Desktop, and it works fine for me. So go ahead and find your install for Falcon BMS. Go to User, Config, scroll down to your CFG files, and find your server CFG. This is used for servers. This is if you have two computers or a dedicated server. You would put all of your settings in here. Some of these settings include no render, which is what I have here, so you don't have to have a graphics card for the server. It helps a lot. I do have a graphics card, but I use it anyway. If you have a self-host and you only have one computer, you can put all these settings in the BMS user, and that'll work. If you put the settings in Falcon BMS, it'll get rewritten every time you update. So make sure you put it into these based on what you're using. Like I said, this is my settings. You don't have to copy it. It'll still work if you leave it blank, but these are just some of the things that I do on my server. So here are some things that I think is important. You have the force minimum client bandwidth settings. This forces when someone joins, this forces them to put more than 2,500 in the box when you join a server. If you put less than that, it'll give them error. When someone joins, you don't want them to join as the default bandwidth. It gives problems and the game starts to lag because of the slow bandwidth. So you can change that to what you want. Taxi launch time is when everybody's ready in 2D on the countdown screen. The countdown timer will count down to 10 minutes and then it'll launch everyone in. Remember, the server needs to be in-game 1 minute before the taxi launch time. So the server will go into at 11 minutes, and it'll 1 minute later, everyone else will go in for taxi launch. For a ramp start, that number is now 17. So it'll let everyone in at 17 minutes. It's no render is literally what you see on the screen behind here. It won't render the graphics of the BMS game. So technically, you don't need a powerful computer to be able to run a server in BMS. One is for no video, and zero is for video. Or you can just remove this line altogether. So this right here, this next line, is campaign period, save in minutes. This is actual campaign time. It's not real time. Especially if you have the campaign paused, if there's no one in the campaign, which you can have that option later on. So every 60 in-game minutes, it'll save a automatic save. The Fog of War save is zero. That means if someone saves the campaign, they'll be able to see everyone in the campaign, even the other side. So I have this at zero because it's only a few of us, but if you have a large group, I might recommend to change that to one so someone can't just save the campaign and be able to see the other side in other software and open up in the campaign and can see the other side. So this deag timer is when the AI spawns leading up to taxiing. So in 8 minutes, all the AI spawns when there's 8 minutes left in there before their takeoff time. Server compression mode is one. Zero is default. One is what I have it set to. Server pauses without player. So if there's no one in the 2D logged into your server in the actual campaign, the timer is paused. Once they log in, it'll go to times one and everything will be normal. If you have a two, server pauses without player, so it's the same thing, but the player can control server acceleration. So once they're in, they can actually control the acceleration of the server. If you want to learn more about the settings that you can place in the config file, go ahead and go to your BMS technical manual. The no render is on page 3-34. So make sure you look in there, and if you want to copy paste it, you could use this as well. If you have any questions, go ahead and feel free to ask in the comments, but make sure that you're utilizing the BMS user manual or any other questions and step-by-step instructions how to host your server. This dogfight module here is a very basic way to get into 3D really fast. It's kind of like a free flight, I guess, but you can also fight others. So usually I use match play. So you have two teams. Once you do that, go ahead and commit online. This will create a online session where your friend will log into your server and press online, and it'll come up as a game here. So make sure that they're looking in the online tab if they're looking for your game. So saved. Match play, going to press commit online. Leave all this by default. So once you created the game, make sure you create the game first before your friend joins. Sometimes it does weird stuff. So you are automatically on the red team. Once your friend joins, have them join on the orange team so you could be opposite of each other. You could right click, change your aircraft, which you want to fly. Also, your opponent can go on the other side. They'll just press join. Once they press join, they'll be on the other side on the orange team. They can do the same. If you want to be on the same team, your friend will join in. It'll create two lines of aircraft here. Have them right click on you and press join. It'll join in on your flight here and it'll be easier to see each other. If you just want to go against AI, you press this small button here with the plus sign. You press it. You choose what aircraft you want it to be, the skill level you want it to be, and the call sign that you want it to have, press OK, and now you have one. If you want to add another one, right click, add pilot, and you add the skill level, and that's two. Over here to the left, you got your unlimited guns, ECM. Don't worry about BVR tactic. You can choose random, it's just different tactics that the AI uses. Range, altitude, points that you need to get for the game to reset. If you die, don't worry about exiting, just eject and the game will reset itself. As long as one team has been killed, it'll reset the game and you'll try again. Radar missiles, all aspect, and rear aspect. Over here, you can move the box around where your arena will be. Here, you can change the time, and this is the weather in this box here. After that, press takeoff, and you'll be in 3D shortly. Whoever is hosting this dogfight mode, make sure they exit last, or you'll give the other clients, they'll have to force close their BMS. So make sure you exit after everyone else exits. Hope this video helped you, and I'll see you next time.